This is a special place. You might not see it in the homely old stands, the plain wooden seats. No frills, nothing fancy, not a single modern amenity. Just hot dogs and beer and football. The players certainly don't find it romantic. The dressing rooms are the worst in the league, and fans, at least out-of-town fans, aren't inclined to consider this a cozy, nostalgic sports shrine, a place to be cherished, a Fenway Park, a Wrigley Field. Truth is, Ivor Wynne Stadium is an octogenarian, built for the 1930 British Empire Games that has seen far better days.
On the 7-yard line for the Hamilton Tiger Cats, a gain to Cohey, touchdown!
But seen through some eyes, including these eyes, born in this city, living in this city, coming here for more than 40 years, Ivor Wynne is an essential part of home.
I'm one short block away from the stadium. My name is Robin McPherson, and I've been a Ticat fan for 56 years.
Remember my first game? It was in 68, and it was Winnipeg Hamilton. It was called Civic Stadium at that time. Growing up, you know, you grew up, it's there. It's always been in the heart of the city.
Now its time is nearly done. Now it's on the clock. This old pile will soon be gone, and so many things will change. The Ticats' new digs won't be tucked right into the middle of a working-class neighborhood. There won't be people waving cars in to park on front lawns, sometimes lawns that aren't even their own. There won't be seats almost to the edge of the playing field, creating a unique sense of intimacy, of connection, and of danger for any player who strays too close to the wall. There won't be so many obvious reminders of glorious Ticats' past, of tough teams that mirrored a tough town, and were an essential part of its identity. No pretending here. Hamilton is a very different place than it once was. The steel mills that have always been the city's backdrop are no longer its lifeblood. Their place in how Hamiltonians see themselves has become more symbolic than real. And perhaps you could say the same about the Tiger Cats. Not everyone here lives and breathes them anymore. And so when it comes time to say goodbye to Ivor Wynne, not everyone will be mourning. Even for many diehard fans, it will be at worst the sad but inevitable passing of a place that has lived a long and useful and colorful life. But for some of us, it will be a bit more than that. Squint a little bit, at least if you're of a certain age, and you can still see the stadium before artificial turf, when this was the worst, muddiest field in the Canadian Football League, when for a time the North Stands were considered too shabby to be shown on television. Remember the names of heroes past. Filoni, Barrow, Mosca, Henley, Ely, Sunter, Carrigan, Covington, McManus, Flutie, and standing on the sideline, the little general. Think back to the only modern era Grey Cups played here, the glorious last play victory by the home team in 1972.
It's good! The Hamilton Tiger Cats defeat the Saskatchewan Roughriders 13-10.
And that crazy snowball in 1996.
Double blue and Grey Cup champions in 1996.
And of course, there was that time that Pink Floyd blew up the scoreboard. A lot of us are going to miss this dump. This dirty, ugly, beautiful dump. Well, maybe not the Argos.